please join us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. You may be seated.
Good afternoon. At this time, I would like to take a moment to give you a very warm welcome to Har-Ber High School's senior celebration for the class of 2012. we are so honored and privileged to have each of you here today. I'd like to give a special welcome to Dr. Jim Rollins, Superintendent of Springdale Public Schools. And I would also like to give a special welcome to all of our honored guests, our honorees, our seniors, class of 2012, and of course, every one of your family members and friends that are in attendance today. Yes. A quick note to parents and guests and seniors before we start, Life Touch Photography will be photographing today's event. In your graduation packets, there were information about how to purchase these online. Each senior was given a graduation packet with that information, and if you do not have that information, you can check our school website. At this time, please welcome to the podium the senior class president of 2012, Ms. Bethany Joseph.
William Boyd is a graduate of Pine Bluff High School and attended the University of Arkansas to pursue a major in political science. After graduating, he earned a Master of Arts in Teaching. Mr. Boyd has been teaching in the district for 8 years and is proud to say that six of them he has invested in the students at Har-Ber High School. During this time, he taught many social sciences, including AP World History and AP Psychology. He currently lives in Fort Smith and has been married to his wife, Jennifer, for 29 years. Together, they have two kids, Will and Molly. The real reason we asked him to speak on behalf of the class of 2012 is that he is beloved and a greatly revered teacher at Har-Ber High School. His students view his class as very intriguing and testify that he is a teacher passionate about his students.
Thank you, Bethany. Seniors. Wow, what an excellent crowd. I want to say what a pleasure and a privilege it is, first of all, to be asked to speak to you today. And additionally, I've received a lot of kindly advice about the preparation of my remarks to you today. Advice like, don't teach, don't preach, keep it short, don't mess it up, and the all-encompassing, ever helpful, you sure you got this, Mr. Boyd? Right. So in an effort to abide by the time limits I've got, and I know we have a lot going on here today to honor you, and some of you will appreciate this a little more than others, but I've prepared a way to sort of expedite my remarks. So I've put them on a really small concept map to sort of help speed things along. Okay, made you look. This is really a great occasion for you graduates. I want you to reflect and ponder just a moment on what you've experienced over the last few years here at Har-Ber High School and how you've grown as a person. I can promise you that it hasn't gone unnoticed by your teachers and those that are the closest to you. You've overcome many personal and academic challenges to be able to sit in the seat that you're sitting in at this time. I want to remind you of just a few of those. You've studied hard, and you've survived some pretty rigorous testing. You've enhanced your intellectual capacity far beyond what you thought you were capable of. You've crammed, you procrastinated, you've completed all your assignments, you've become an expert at time management. You've marveled at how easy it is to find a parking place at Har-Ber High School. You've held jobs. You've created projects. You've written some pretty stellar papers. You've logged on to Facebook. Some of you have texted so many messages this year that you've expanded the size of your thumbs. You've laughed. You've cried. We've laughed together. We've cried together. You've questioned the mysteries of life while accepting the wisdom of others. You've done a great many things that we and you are proud of. And yes, you've probably done a few things that you just as soon forget. But you've made tough decisions. And then we've watched as those tough decisions made you. Without question, the experiences I believe that you've had here at Har-Ber High School are going to serve you well, whatever it is that you decide to do in the future. And as you ponder the future, ladies and gentlemen, which I'm sure you will, either now or later, there's a few things I want you to remember. We don't live unto ourselves in this world. We all make an impact, for good or bad. We are all observed. We are all watched. We are all examples for others, lessons for good or for bad. So, since I'm here, and I've got the podium at this moment, I'm going to tell you what the old guy thinks, okay? So here's what the old guy thinks. I think you are exceptional. I think you are gifted. I think you're talented. I think you are unique. I think that you are meant to be right here, right now. I think you've been placed here to complete mission possible. I think you've been gifted with a brain that's filled with ideas that have yet to be formulated. No matter what task that you decide to do in the future, you've been designed to complete it in the spirit of excellence. To compete against your best efforts to date is your goal. I'd like to wrap this up and finish up with a quote. And you may have heard me say it before, but it bears repeating. A gentleman named Roy Disney said it. You may be a little more familiar with his brother Walt. Roy Disney said this: "It's not hard to make decisions when you know what your values are." So with that in mind, I want to say this to you. It doesn't matter whether others approve or disapprove of who you are or what you do. Your responsibility is to do your best. So be proud of who you are and what you've achieved. Take the measure of talent that you have and use it. Expand it. Share it. And whatever the next step for you is, be a lifelong learner. Don't compromise your integrity by seeking outward approval. Maintain your integrity by only ever seeking inward and upward approval, because that's all that really matters. Again, I want to say congratulations to everyone, and thanks for giving me the honor on behalf of Har-Ber High School of telling you how proud we are of each and every one of you. Thanks a lot.
Help you through when you've done all you can do. His countenance upon you,
and give you peace,
and give you peace,
and give you peace,
and give you peace.
The Lord make
his face to shine upon you, and be gracious unto you,
and be gracious.
The Lord be gracious, gracious unto you.
Amen, amen,
amen, amen,
amen,
amen,
amen.
What an honor and privilege it is to serve at Har-Ber High School, our seventh graduating class, 472. We celebrate you today. We have many awards and honors and scholarships that we want to announce today, and so we'll be as expeditiously working as possible. We ask your patience and indulgence as we want to honor each and every one to the utmost. At this time, well, there's a series of honors where students will stand when I call their name, and you will applaud for them appropriately. Each October, juniors taking the PSAT test may qualify to enter the National Merit Scholarship Program. If their score meets or exceeds the selection index score, then they are selected. Today, we are recognizing a National Merit Program with a letter of commendation for her exceptional academic promise demonstrated by her outstanding performance on the PSAT. Please help me recognize Sarah Zimmerman. The Principal's Leadership Award is sponsored by the National Association of Secondary School Principals and is given to one senior each year. This student is recommended by the building principal and for their demonstrated ability in academic excellence and exemplary leadership in the roles that they hold in the school and community activities. The Principal's Leadership Award values the importance of well-rounded education. This year, the award goes to Evan Verucci. The Arkansas Governor's Scholars Day is held at the Governor's Mansion each year in May. Scholars Day honors each Arkansas high school's top two graduates from each high school in the state. This is determined by their cumulative grade point average and college preparatory curriculum. We'd like to honor and recognize as they stand today, Spencer Nelson and Andrew Casey. Har-Ber High School has 121 honor graduates. They're wearing a gold honor cord. They will also wear these Saturday afternoon at their commencement exercises. These seniors have completed the college preparatory curriculum, which includes math beyond algebra 2, plus chemistry or physics, 2 years of the same foreign language. In addition, at least 2 advanced placement courses are required and a final cumulative grade point average of 3.5 or greater. This is based on their entire high school career, grades 9 through 12. These scholars are also recognized at graduation. Some have completed 2 to 3 AP courses, signifies honors. There are 26 students. 4 to 5 AP courses signifies high honors. There are 28 students. And 6 or more AP courses is recognized as highest honors, and there are 67 total students in that category. At this time, I would like all 121 honor graduates to be stand and be recognized. As we continue today, you will understand some of the academic work that these students have done as they'll be recognized by universities around the country with scholarships. The United States Presidential Scholars Program was established in 1964 to recognize and honor some of our nation's most distinguished graduating high school seniors. Only 3,000 seniors in America are identified and invited to apply, where 500 are then named semifinalists. Ultimately, only 141 nationwide are named presidential scholars. Today, we would like to recognize the students that have been invited to be a part of this program for representing Har-Ber High School. As they stand, please honor them. Alex Ross and Sky Dominguez. The Arkansas Times, a weekly newspaper published in Little Rock, Arkansas, announces its academic all-star each spring. This is the only statewide publication that recognizes outstanding students in Arkansas. There were two students nominated for the honor here from Har-Ber High School, and at this time we would recognize them as well. One was recognized as one of the top 20 on the all-star team and was also recognized in the Arkansas Times. The representatives from Har-Ber High School are Zach Ford and Jessica Anderson. The Northwest Arkansas newspapers also have an all-academic team. It's comprised of nominees in the four-county Northwest Arkansas region who are judged on the academic performance, community service, and overall contribution to their school. This year's Har-Ber recognizes a student that was featured in last Sunday's edition of the Morning News. Y'all honor her as she stands, Miss Bethany Joseph. The DAR Good Citizen Award is sponsored by the National Society of Daughters of the American Revolution. The DAR Good Citizen must possess the qualities of dependability, service, leadership, and patriotism. The Har-Ber High School faculty have selected their representative this year, Azrael Nahira Bahina. Please stand. The Kiwanis Youth Excellent Award goes to a student who demonstrates the desire to overcome challenges in their life and to put others before themselves. It is the human cause accomplishments of these youth that touch the hearts of lives of many of those around them. This year, the Har-Ber High School faculty selects for this award, as she stands, please recognize, Charity Luster. For 70 years, the American Legion Boys State and American Legion Auxiliary Girls State have given an inside look at the demands of good citizenship and civic responsibility to tomorrow's citizens and future leaders. Delegates learned firsthand government operations at the local country and state level. Our representative, Kyle Witzigman, was the first Springdale student in 30 years to be selected to represent Arkansas at Boys Nation in Washington, D.C. Let's help me recognize Kyle Witzigman. Once again, let me extend my welcome, and as we quickly go through our awards today, I would like to welcome to the stage Armed Services representatives for two special presentations.
Good afternoon, Dr. Brackett, Ms. Foster, parents, students, faculty, and of course, the graduating class of 2012. Thank you for inviting me today. My name is Sergeant First Class Jean Genereux. I'm your Army Reserve Career Counselor for the Fayetteville-Springdale area. Today at Har-Ber High School, we want to continue what's become a grand tradition, the Army Reserve Scholar Athlete Award. Could I please have Emma Gartner and John Vaughn to the stage? These students. Thank you. They look a little nervous, don't they? This does not put you in the Army. This is, You have been selected by the school, you've been nominated, to receive the Army Reserve National Scholar Athlete Award. This was created in 1981 to honor chosen students in high schools across the nation. Today's recipients join 130,000 high school students who have been chosen since 1981. Today you'll be receiving a certificate that has been signed by Lieutenant General Jack Schultz, Chief of the Army Reserve Command, and an Army Reserve Medallion. These students have achieved excellence in both academics and athletics. John has achieved the academic and athletic scholarships. He is graduating with the highest honors and excels in football and basketball. He maintains a 3.9 grade point average. This year, Emma Gartner is our female awardee. She is in the National Honor Society, is graduating with the highest honors, has athletic scholarships to Concordia University, and she is the All-State Athlete, Team MVP, and All-Conference Athlete for 2011. She is also the Northwest Arkansas Lightning Team Coach, and she maintains a 4.06 grade point average. Let's give these two a round of applause for being the Army Reserve Scholar Athlete recipients.
Good afternoon. My name is Staff Sergeant Maskell. I'm with the United States Marine Corps, and I'd like to first offer congratulations to the parents and educators for their commitment and example to the students. I would also like to congratulate all the graduating seniors on their achievement. First off, I have two students, Jacob Lee and Evan Verucci. Please join me up here. Now, these two students were selected not only by their counselors and their teachers, but as well as their coaches to receive two awards. The first award is the Scholastic Excellence Award. Now, the Marine Corps believes that encouraging students to sharpen their minds is a key ingredient to success. We are proud to honor students who display the same high level of character and integrity as United States Marines. These students' Marine-like traits of personal diligence and will to achieve high standards of personal performance make it a pleasure to present them with the Scholastic Excellence Award. Now, the second award that they will be receiving is the Distinguished Athlete Award. Now, honor, courage, and commitment are Marine traits also needed to be a successful athlete, to push beyond your boundaries and make the most of your personal abilities. The Marines are proud to honor students who display the will to win and other Marine-like attributes. It is a pleasure to present, once again, Evan Verucci and Jacob Lee with this Distinguished Athlete Award.
Good afternoon. My name is Colleen Foster, and I'm a lead counselor here at Harber, and we are pleased today to have several guests that are presenting scholarships to Harber seniors. Each scholarship presenter will come to the podium, introduce themselves, name the recipients of the scholarship, read the criteria, and lead in applause. And then seniors, when you're those of you that are seated on stage, you'll come forward when your name is called, and after the presentation, you may exit the stage with them to go have a photo made, and later on, when your graduation photos are posted online, you will use the same code if you want to order a scholarship picture. Okay, the first presenter may now come forward.
Good afternoon, faculty, staff, parents, and graduating class 2012. Will the following students please come forward? Stephen Barnes, Sarah Brown, and Logan Hodge. My name is Staff Sergeant Matt Bumgarner, and this is Master Sergeant Thomas Aldridge. We are part of the Arkansas National Guard. These young men and women today have enlisted in the National Guard and are being awarded the Arkansas National Guard Scholarship. The award they're being presented today certifies that these soldiers of Har-Ber High School have earned college education benefits, including federal tuition assistance, the Montgomery GI Bill, and Guard Tuition Incentive Program valued at $50,420 while serving as members in the Arkansas Army National Guard. They are recognized for their dedicated service to the great state of Arkansas and the United States of America. Give them a round of applause.
Hello, I'm Diana Gilbert with Community Blood Center of the Ozarks. I'm here today to present the Students of Life Scholarship Award. May Haley Guthrie please join me on the stage? Thanks to contributions from local hospitals, we at Community Blood Center are able to give out 40 scholarships a year across 38 counties. A special thank you to Kim Biondo and the Student Council for hosting our blood drives. Har-Ber students and staff gave 210 donations of blood this school year. Today, I am honored to present a $500 scholarship to Haley Guthrie. Congratulations.
Will Ashley Snow and Aaron Sisko please join me at the podium? I am proud to announce the scholarships of Robert Boatwright's S&A Food Service. We raise money by doing fundraisers as bake sales, pan sales, etc. We, the cafeteria workers, are committed into supporting our Springdale School students. Thank you.
Good afternoon, faculty, students, and class of Springdale Har-Ber 2012. My name is Sergeant Black. I'm the Army Career Counselor for this school. At this time, would Dustin Bartram please come to the stage, Matthew Kellogg, and Cody Yule. Today, I would like to acknowledge these students for taking the step to secure not only their future, but our nation's future as well. These students have truly risen to the challenge. They will be serving our country as a soldier in the United States Army for approximately 3 to 6 years. One of their benefits to serving our country is receiving a scholarship to be used at a college of their choice. Dustin Bartram will be receiving $39,420 for school. Matthew Kellogg will be receiving $69,828. And Cody Yule will be receiving $74,328.
Good afternoon, I'm Jonathan Vest, Assistant Director of Admissions at the University of Central Arkansas. Honored to be here today to represent UCA. Will Victoria Hittle, Jamie Perry, Savannah Sluter, Garrett Cooper, Kelly Toomer, and Sarah Zimmerman please join me on stage? These students' outstanding academic achievement have earned them scholarships to the University of Central Arkansas. Victoria Hittle will receive a university scholarship valued at $10,000. Jamie Perry will also receive a university scholarship valued at $10,000, as will Savannah Sluter receive receive a university scholarship valued at $10,000. Receiving an achievement scholarship, Garrett Cooper and Kelly Toomer, valued at $20,000, and receiving our highest honor scholarship, Sarah Zimmerman, with a distinguished scholarship valued at $34,000. Collectively, this group has earned more than $100,000 in scholarships to UCA. Congratulations, seniors, on your great accomplishments.
My name is Angela Coates, principal at Helster Middle School, and this is Michelle Cook, our PTO president. I just first of all want to tell you how proud we are of all the former heroes I see setting out here and the tradition you started at Helster Middle School. At this time, I would like Zach Ford to join me at the podium. Zach wrote an incredible essay that our PTO board reviewed, and hands down, his stood out above all the rest. Zach is an all-round awesome student. He's an athlete, he's a musician, and he's definitely a scholar. Zach is a real hero. We're so proud.
Would Chad Remy please come to the podium? I'm Keith Moore. I'm representing the Kiwanis Club of Siloam Springs, and it's an honor for me today to present this $500 scholarship to Chad Remy. The qualifications for this scholarship, we give scholarships to the kids, grandkids of our members, and to also officers of our high school age group called the Key Club. So, Chad, congratulations.
Good afternoon. First of all, I'd like to congratulate the entire class of 2012. And at this time, I would like Jamie Perry, Jared Adams, and Paxton Hughes to please join me on stage. My name is Jim Ed Reed, and I am the president of Springdale Kiwanis Club, and I'm here to present the Springdale Kiwanis Scholarships. Each recipient received a scholarship in the amount of $750. The recipients were chosen based on their academic achievements, their extracurricular activities, and their overall academic goals. Please help me in congratulating Jamie Perry, Jared Adams, and Paxton Hughes.
Good afternoon, Har-Ber High School students, parents, faculty, and friends. My name is Holly Moore, and I'm an Assistant Director of Admissions at the University of Arkansas. Would the following scholarship recipients please join me at the podium? Jarrett Adams, receiving a freshman academic scholarship valued at $1,000. Milo Bailey, receiving a freshman academic scholarship valued at $1,000. Zachary Ball, receiving a Chancellor's scholarship valued at $32,000. Brittany Booth, receiving a leadership scholarship valued at $8,000. Erica Brockunier, receiving a freshman academic scholarship valued at $1,000. Amanda Brashwee, receiving a freshman academic scholarship valued at $1,000. Kelsey Carmian receiving a freshman academic scholarship valued at $1,000. Andrew Casey receiving an honors college fellowship valued at $50,000. Mallory Cheater receiving a freshman academic scholarship valued at $1,000. Caitlin Davis receiving a leadership scholarship valued at $8,000. Spencer Erickson receiving a chancellor's scholarship valued at $32,000. Haley Guthrie receiving an Honors College Academy scholarship valued at $16,000. Mark Hall receiving an Honors College Academy scholarship valued at $16,000. Luke Hansen receiving a freshman academic scholarship valued at $1,000. Riley Harris receiving an Honors College Academy scholarship valued at $16,000. Riley Harris is also receiving a Razorback Generation scholarship through the Arkansas Alumni Association. Isaac Herrera receiving a Silas Hunt scholarship valued at $20,000. Michelle Howard receiving a freshman academic scholarship valued at $1,000. Lucas Endorf receiving a freshman academic scholarship valued at $1,000. Karina Marqueda receiving a Silas Hunt scholarship valued at $20,000. Alex McGowan receiving a Chancellor scholarship valued at $32,000. Spencer Nelson receiving an Honors College fellowship valued at $50,000. Emma Ridings receiving a Chancellor's Community scholarship valued at $20,000. Alexander Ross receiving a Chancellor scholarship valued at $32,000. Margaret Rushing receiving a Leadership scholarship valued at $8,000. Alexandria Sharam receiving a Freshman Academic scholarship valued at $1,000. And Catherine Snively receiving a Freshman Academic scholarship valued at $1,000. These scholarships vary in amounts and are based on many different criteria involving leadership, community involvement, and academic achievements. I'm honored to be here to celebrate with you the exceptional achievements of this class, and particularly those seniors today who have received these scholarships. This list may not include all the scholarships awarded by the University of Arkansas, but today I would like to announce that collectively we have awarded $498,000 in scholarships to Har-Ber High School students for the next 4 years. Would you please join me in congratulating this exceptional group on their outstanding achievements?
Can I get Jordan Freisinger to join me at the podium, please? My name is Danny Hobson, and I'm here to present the Karen Hobson Pierce Memorial Scholarship. Her family is with me to present this award. I have her mother, Judy Hobson, her lifelong friend, Jerry McWaters, and her daughter, Sydney Pierce. As some of you know, Mrs. Pierce was an amazing music teacher in Springdale at both, George, Bayari, and Walker Elementary. Her work ethic, dedication, absolute love, passion for her students remains an inspiration to all of us. Today, we honor her memory by awarding her scholarship to a student who has also shown dedication and hard work in both her academics and to her community. Her continued involvement in her school and community make Jordan the perfect candidate for this scholarship. So it is our great privilege to award the first Karen Hobson Pierce Memorial Scholarship in the amount of $1,000 to Jordan Freisinger.
Can Morgan Ritz join me?
My
My name is Ellen Rainey, and I'm a Spanish teacher here at Har-Ber High School, and I'm presenting the Springdale Education Association Scholarship. It is for $500, and it is for a student with outstanding academics and who plans to pursue a career in teaching. This is Morgan Ritz.
Hi, my name is Casey Phipps, and I have actually had the privilege of teaching many of the seniors as a fifth grade and kindergarten teacher at Young Elementary. I am the literacy specialist now, and I am here to present a scholarship from Young Elementary to Ms. Evan Varuki and Ms. Erin Green, so if you could join me up here. We are very proud of all of our former students. It was a very, very tough decision this year, and we are proud of every single student who has come through Young Elementary. But congratulations, girls.
Will Samantha Teeter please come up? My name is Tanya Plegenkuhl, and I'm the president of the Helen Tyson PTO, and we just want to recognize Samantha for being an outstanding student. You've displayed leadership at our school as well as academic achievement. You have represented Helen Tyson very well, and we congratulate you.
Good afternoon. I'm Debbie Creek, and this is Jacob Donahoe. We're with Harps Food Stores, and we need to have Isaac Herrera, Micah Bender, Alec Phillip, and Hannah Jones join us at the podium, please. Harps is really excited to have given over $100,000 in scholarships during the last 10 years to graduating seniors in our communities. Based on several criteria, we select the recipients of these scholarships from the graduating seniors who are either employed with us or have a parent who is. So we're very excited today to present a $1,000 scholarship to each of, we're missing one, I guess, but the four recipients. Alec Phillip, his mother, Jamie Slayton, is our assistant controller at the office. Micah Bender's mother, Rebecca, is our scanning coordinator at Price Cutter. Isaac Herrera's dad, Juan, manages our meat department at Price Cutter. And Hannah Jones is an outstanding employee at our Har-Ber store. And congratulations, guys. We wish you guys all the best.
Hi, could Karina Marqueda and Kelsey Carmine please join us up here? Hi, I'm Lisa Will, and this is Deidre Ashcraft from Har-Ber PTSO. This year, we are awarding two $500 scholarships to students that we feel will make a difference in the world. Our criteria was scholastic merit, service to the community, and character. We're proud to present these scholarships in the amount of $500 to Kelsey and Karina.
Good afternoon. I'm Rusty Sykes. I'm from Simmons Foods. And would Hannah Elaine Cook please join me on the stage?
So John Morris, Director of Operations for Simmons Pet Food Division. We have Alex McGowan to the stage.
I'm Ted Dorn. Would Haley Hudlow join us?
I'm Brett Garten, Director of Purchasing. And would Caitlin O'Loughlin come to the podium, please?
Each year, Simmons recognizes Each year, Simmons recognizes seniors from our employees or producers, and we award over $50,000 in scholarships annually to these students. Thank you.
Will Jesus de la Sancha please come to the podium? My name is Tanya Woods, assistant principal, and I am representing T.G. Smith Elementary, the staff, PTA, and proud principal, Kim Simcoe, who would like to say congratulations to all the graduates. We would like to represent Mr. Jesus de la Sancha in a $1,000 scholarship that's presented by our school and our PTA, and he was a Smith Stallion all 6 years. Congratulations.
Hello, my name is Bonnie Culp King, and I'm here representing my husband, Thomas Culp, who was a wonderful teacher here at Har-Ber High several years ago, and he realized his dream of being the AP biology teacher here. And he represented well his character and his academic achievement, and he chose in high school, he knew that he wanted to influence lives. And so when he went on to college, he wasn't sure what he wanted to do. But he knew he wanted to impact students in some way, so he thought about pre-med for a while and then decided, no, I want to be a teacher. And when he decided that, he knew he wanted to teach biology, and he knew he wanted to be at Har-Ber High. And so he ended up at Har-Ber High, and it's with a great honor that I'm here to represent the family and his memory. We have the Thomas Culp Memorial Scholarship here recipients, Connor Robertson and Jacob Lee, if you'll join me. I have here the academic scholarship recipient, Connor Robertson, who gets $1,000, and he's at the University of Arkansas right now. And I have up here Jacob Lee, who is the character scholarship recipient for $1,000.
Hello and good afternoon. My name is Mitch Stiles. I'm with Ozarks Electric. Could I please get Evan Verucki and Hannah Cook to join me? On behalf of Ozarks Electric, I'd like to say congratulations to all the seniors on your accomplishments. Each year I get to travel around and present scholarships to each of the schools that lie in our service territory. It's a $1,000 scholarship, and this year's Har-Ber High School win goes to Evan and Hannah, so give them a round of applause. Thank you.
If I could have Stormy Doak please come to the podium. Never been accused of being quiet. That's amazing. My name is Denise Pellin, and I'm here representing the Springdale Schools Alumni Foundation. We give scholarships out each year based off need, recommendations from former alumni, and an essay written by the student, and it is my honor to present the Springdale Schools Alumni Foundation Martha Langford Scholarship to Stormy Doak.
How y'all doing? I'm Sergeant Cox with the United States Air Force. Can I get Sam Purser up here? All right, today Today I have the privilege of awarding Sam the Montgomery GI Bill worth up to $70,000 for tuition. He's met the requirements, the strict requirements that it requires to get in the United States Air Force. So again, help me in congratulating him.
Will Morgan Ritz please join us? Good afternoon. My name is Jim Anse, and I'm also with Harps Food Stores. The Debbie Hofforth Harp Scholarship Fund was established in memory of Debbie Hofforth, a long-term Harps associate and a 1980 Springdale grad. I'm honored to be joined by Debbie's husband, David, and her daughter, Jessica, both also Springdale grads. We're delighted to announce that this year's recipient of a $1,000 scholarship is Morgan, who will be pursuing a degree in early childhood education at John Brown University.
Will Iris Mancia please join me at the podium? My name is Marcy Levesey, and I'm with the Career Academy of Hair Design. This is Kristen Ferentz. She's with the Career Academy of Hair Design Springdale location. And we are awarding Iris Mancia the Skills USA Arkansas two-year tuition-free WAVE scholarship.
Would Raul Najeda Bajena, Karina Maqueda, and Isaac Herrera please join me at the podium? Good afternoon. My name is Hilda Gomez, and I am the past president of the League of United Latin American Citizens, Council 754, here in Northwest Arkansas. LULAC is the oldest Hispanic civil rights organization in the United States. Locally, we have awarded more than 184 scholarships, totaling more than $187,000 since 2001. It is my pleasure to present these students with their scholarship. Raul Najera with a $1,000 scholarship. Karina Maqueda with a $1,000 scholarship. And Isaac Herrera with a 750 general scholarship. Thank you.
Good afternoon. My name is Diana Johnson. I'm with Northwest Arkansas Community College, and I'm extremely happy today to award the Northwest Arkansas Community College Trustee Scholarship to Stormy Doak.
Hello, I'm Rolf Wilkin, president of the Springdale Rotary Club, and I'm proud to award the Willard Walker Rotary Scholarship for General Awesomeness to Kelsey Carmine. Congratulations.
We have a Jack and Glenna Helstern scholarship, and we had 15 applicants for this scholarship, and the committee decided, let's just share the love. So everybody's getting a $200 book scholarship, and if these students would come forward, Molly Alvarado, Kelsey Carmian, Andrew Casey, K- Caitlin Davis, Zach Ford, Haley Guthrie, Isa Carrera, Morgan Ritz, Paxson Hughes, Amy Kelso, Karina Makeda, Jamie Perry, Alex Ross, Evan Verucki, Kyle Witzigman. Let's give them a round of applause. Students, your certificate about this scholarship will be in your diploma packet, okay? And you may all go over and get your picture made.
Congratulations, graduates. What a great day this is. We're also very proud of each of you. If I could ask Allison Stamps to come to the Hello, Allison. The Rodeo of the Ozarks, the Springdale Benevolent Association, has served this community for well over 60 years. Allison, we're pleased today to present you a scholarship for $1,000 per year for 4 years. Congratulations.
As Evan and Isaac Johnson join me on stage, I'd like to invite Isaac Herrera to also join us. At this time, we're going to honor the memory of Coach Kevin Johnson. I worked with Kevin beginning in 2001, and I remember having lunch duty every day. His humor, his stability, his Christian influence has touched many, not only in this audience and community around this state, and around this country. His legacy of dedication, commitment, and work ethic will forever be remembered and honored in the Kevin Johnson Memorial Scholarship sponsored by the Springdale School Education Foundation. The first recipient of this annual scholarship will be presented by Coach Johnson's sons, Evan and Isaac, and the first recipient of $1,000 Kevin Johnson Memorial Scholarship is Isaac Herrera.
Good afternoon. My name is Alana Clark, and I am one of the counselors here at Harber. I have all the students' last names A through E. Over 200 Harber seniors have applied for scholarships through the Arkansas Department of Education. This includes the Arkansas Academic Challenge, nicknamed the Lottery Scholarship, which is currently worth up to $18,000 at $4,500 per year if attending a four-year university, or $2,250 per year at a two-year college. As a reminder, seniors who have not yet applied have until June 1st to do so. Will all seniors who applied for and will receive the Arkansas Academic Challenge Scholarship please stand? In addition to those already recognized, many seniors have received scholarships and have self-reported to the Counseling Center. Others have been awarded scholarships that we were recently notified by the organization. Will each senior please stand as your name is called and be seated as the next student's name is called? Audience, please hold your applause until the end of this portion. Jarrett Adams, University of Arkansas Engineering Scholarship. Jessica Anderson, Arkansas Tech Distinguished Scholars and the T.C. and Maudine Sanders Scholarship. Manuel Avalar, Robinson Avenue Church of Christ and the Robinson Avenue Iglesia of De Cristo Scholarship. Hannah Bender, University Centrium Scholarship at Henderson State University. Jacob Berry, Ecclesia College Basketball Scholarship. Haley Boatwright, National Center of Women Information Technology Award for Aspirations in Computing, University of Arkansas Engineering Academy Scholarship, and the University of Arkansas Technology Awareness Program Award. Candler Burtz, Texas Christian University Dean Scholarship. Brittany Booth, Fraternal Order of Police Scholarship. Sonia Bonkong, Bilingual CNA Scholarship. Blake Bratcher, Arkansas Tech University Coral Foundation Fellowship and Arkansas Tech University Distinguished Scholars. Amanda Brochui, Coca-Cola Scholarship. Renisha Brown, University of Central Arkansas Vocal Scholarship. Elias Campuzano, the Crowder Migrant Scholarship. Kelsey Carmine, Best Buy Scholarship, Dr. Seuss Facebook Challenge Scholarship, Elks Lodge Most Valuable Student Scholarship, and Federal Law Enforcement Foundation Scholarship. Andrew Casey, Arkansas Governor's Distinguished Scholarship. Isabella Clark, University of the Ozarks Academic Achievement Scholarship and the University of the Ozarks Theater Arts Scholarship. Caitlin Crane, Independence Community College Academic and Volleyball Scholarship. Caitlin Davis, Elks Lodge Scholarship. Adriana Del Pilar, Hispanic Women's Organization Scholarship. And Kay Hueve Cafe Scholarship and the University of Arkansas Band Scholarship. Stormy Doak, Springdale Alumni Scholarship and $500 to Whitlock Orthodontics. Sky Dominguez, Eminence Research Study Abroad Grant at Ohio State University, Eminence Scholarship at Ohio State University, and the National Buckeye Scholarship at Ohio State University. Spencer Erickson, Arkansas Governor's Scholarship. Caroline Eubanks, Arkansas Tech Athletic Scholarship. Rocio Eusebio, the Crowder Migrant Scholarship.
I'm Dave Klaus. I'm privileged to work with the students' last names F through L as counselor. Will the following students please stand, and we're going to hold applause until I finish the whole group, please. Shanayla Fawcett, Brigham Young University Scholarship. Michael Fine, Arkansas Tech Athletic Scholarship. Zach Ford, State Farm Companies Foundation Scholarship. Emma Gartner, Concordia University Regents Scholarship, Concordia University Soccer Athletic Scholarship, and the Fayetteville Springdale Elks Lodge Scholarship. Grant Gershner, Westminster Academic Scholarship, along with a Westminster Choral Scholarship. Aaron Green, Airways Freight Scholarship, as well as a Merit Scholarship to the University of San Francisco. Mark Hall, Arkansas Governor's Distinguished Scholarship. Riley Harris, the Razorback Generation Scholarship to the University of Arkansas. David Hart, David will be receiving the GI Bill scholarship as he joins the United States Navy. Victoria Hittle, the Beta Sigma Pi Memorial Scholarship. Michelle Howard, the United Methodist Women's Scholarship. Morgan Ritz. You cleaned up today, Morgan. All right, here's two more you don't know about. $500 Carroll Electric Scholarship, a $500 Dr. Dwight Duckworth Most Improved Scholarship, in addition to several awards she already knows, John Brown University Scholarship Fund, John Brown University Trustees Academic Award, John E. Brown Founders Award, and the September Fund sponsored by Corey and Jay Radio Show, all to the university, or all to John Brown University. Katie Huff, the Arkansas Tech Academic Scholarship, as well as an Arkansas Tech Athletic Scholarship. Morgan Hughes, Oklahoma Christian University Scholarship, and an additional Oklahoma Christian University Scholarship. Paxton Hughes, Arkansas Tech Cheerleading Scholarship, as well as a Collegiate Academic Scholarship to Arkansas Tech University. Brandon Jansen, Central Methodist University President and Baseball Scholarship. Bethany Joseph. Bethany's received the Fayetteville Springdale Elks Lodge Most Valuable Student Award, the Fayetteville Springdale Elks Lodge Most Valuable Student Scholarship, a Texas A&M University Opportunity Award Scholarship, as well as a Texas A&M University Waiver of Non-Resident Tuition. Billy Landers. My buddy Billy. A full tuition scholarship to Northwest Technical Institute in the amount of $2,400. Jacob Lee, Vanderbilt Financial Aid Scholarship. Serena Llewellyn. Serena is receiving an Abbott and Finner Scholarship as well as a B. Davis Scholarship. Charity Luster. Here's one you don't know about, Charity. A $1,000 Lawrence Schmieding Scholarship. You got it. Let's congratulate these students.
Good afternoon. My name is Alloween Hunter, and I have the alphabet for the students of last name M through R. With Iris Mencia, please stand. She received the Cobb Van Tress Incorporated Scholarship. Karina Makeda. Karina received the St. Raphael Catholic Church Scholarship. Madison McCauley, the Talent Show Scholarship. Alex McGowan, Arkansas Governor's Distinguished Scholarship. Summer Morgan, J. Aaron Hawkins Scholarship, and the University of Arkansas Volleyball Scholarship. Megan Mounts, Arkansas Tech University Fellowship. Spencer Nelson, Arkansas Governor's Distinguished Scholarship. Kelsey Odell, Williams Baptist College Athletic Scholarship and Williams Baptist Leadership Scholarship. Jessica Olson, the Pioneer Scholarship. Jamie Perry, University of Central Arkansas Faculty Scholarship.
Carly Pinalto, Professional Reporters Scholarship, Emily Rainey, Arkansas Tech Distinguished Scholar, and Arkansas Tech Music Scholarship, Ronald Ramos, Crowder College Migrant Scholarship, Valerie Reyna, St. Joseph Catholic Church Scholarship, and University of Arkansas Athletic Scholarship, Addison Roberts, a $2,500 Larkin Heating Air Conditioning sponsored by Clyde and Carolyn Larkin. Elvira Rodriguez, the Hispanic Women's Organization Scholarship. And Alexander Ross, the Arkansas Governor's Distinguished Scholarship. Let's give all these students a big hand.
I'm Colleen Foster, and I have students whose last names start with S through the end of the alphabet, Z. These are students that self-reported, and we're starting with Kelsey Schalkerbauer, scholarships to Coastal Carolina University Scholars Award and Coastal Carolina University Scholar Award. One was an admissions award. Catherine Snavely, University of Arkansas Band Scholarship. Ashley Snow, University of Arkansas at Fort Smith Academic Distinction of Prestige Scholarship. Allison Stamps, the Arkansas High School Rodeo Scholarship, the Debbie Mason FFA Scholarship, the FFA Alumni Booster Club Scholarship, and the National FFA Cargill Community Scholarship. Kimberly Morgan Tate, Missouri State Foundation Scholarship, and Missouri State University Board of Governors Scholarship. Michaela Thompson, Alumni Scholarship to the University of Pittsburgh University. Kelly Toomer, the Morgan Hamilton Memorial Scholarship. Abigail Watley, the Arkansas Assembly of God Fine Arts Award of Merit. Blaise Wynn, Oklahoma State University Achievement Scholarship. Kyle Witzigman, University of Notre Dame Financial Scholarship, University of Notre Dame Hesburgh-USCO Scholars Program, University of Notre Dame Provost Scholarship. Connor Young, and Connor couldn't be here today due to an interview of the college that I'm about to announce. UALR in Little Rock, the Chancellor's Academic Distinction, and the UALR EIT Scholarship. Sarah Zimmerman, the University of Central Arkansas Instrumental Music Scholarship. Let's give all these students a hand.
Okay. Sorry, we have one student that I had omitted accidentally. I need Ubaldo Marquez to please stand.
Yay.
Marquez, thank you. Ubaldo received St. Raphael's Young Men's Scholarship. Congratulations.
My name is Danny Brackett, and I have A through Z. Students, parents, faculty and staff. Dr. Rollins, as you can see, there's a legacy left by the class of 2012 of Har-Ber High School Wildcats. I would be remiss And if I didn't take the opportunity to recognize part of the contributors to their academic success. First of all, I would like to recommend all faculty and staff that are presently in the auditorium, if you would please stand and let's honor you for your work. And students, I hope that before the weekend is over, you'll find those that have touched your lives and thank them for the work that they've done. I'd also be remiss if I didn't recognize the work today of four individuals in this building that have made today possible, and I would like to recognize them especially, and that's our counselors, if you would honor them as well. And then there's a team of people that a few of you get to know very well, students, and that's our administrative team. And I would like to recognize our administrative team, Dr. Michael Shepherd, Ms. Shannon Tischer, and Mr. Aaron Harris, if you would please stand. And students, you will know this more later, but I want to emphasize to you that this weekend is not just about you. There's a group of people here today that have sacrificed, they have disciplined, they've loved, they've punished, they've spent, they have dedicated their lives to seeing that you get to Saturday about 5:30 p.m. And I hope and pray that you'll recognize that as you hug and honor your family this weekend. And I want you now to thank the parents and family members that have seen you through to Saturday. And Dr. Rollins, as I mentioned earlier, there is a legacy that's left by this class. And the legacy could be attributed to many things, but I think that even though they've represented Har-Ber High School and the Springdale School District well in athletics, in activities, in the arts, and they've traveled around the country representing this school and this school district, that's not the legacy that they're leaving. The legacy is academics. A class that I have never seen before to be offered as much scholarship opportunities as this class has been received and has been offered. And I'm continually amazed at the work ethic and the academic prowess of this class. And I think that's the legacy that they will leave. From Duke University to Notre Dame to Vanderbilt to University of Southern California to Ohio State University, University of Virginia, Stanford, Johns Hopkins, Georgetown, University of Michigan, and then the bigger schools. And you've heard some of those. Our students will be taking their work all around the country. It's my honor and privilege to have worked with you for 3 years, and it's my honor and privilege to thank you for what you have done and the accomplishments that you have made. I ask you not to forget us, to please let us know, and we would love to name a football stadium after you. So when you make that first how many ever million? Remember us. Parents, thank you so much for what you've done. At this time, I'd like for everyone to stand as we have the recessional to honor these graduates of 2012. Wait. Y'all gonna go for the video, go ahead. I'm sorry, I almost forgot the senior video. Please have a seat, and as these students come out, they'll see, these students may want to come out and stand. As we prepare for that, appreciate your patience. Immediately following the video, the music will begin, and at that time, we will have our recessional, and as soon as our last graduate is out, we'll be dismissed from these proceedings.
Thank you. expect to learn things I didn't know before, and I guess to make new friends and have a good time. I'm really excited about my senior year.
Out of my senior year, I expect for all the educational stuff that we did freshman through junior year that didn't make sense to finally add up and start making sense, so that way I can apply that to my future projects or situations that I might be in.
Well, for my senior year, I pretty much expect to get some college credit and get a good experience and get some good friends. I'm going to stick around to the U of A for college, so gain some friendships and some connections with people and stick around.
What I want out of my senior year is probably, I just want to have fun with it at the same time, trying to keep my grade point up so I can do that with college. And want to have a good athletic year for baseball. I just want to hope that's successful.
Hi, I'm Victoria Hiddle, and for my senior year, I want everything to be memorable and to not have any regrets when I leave.
And I'm Haley Boatwright, and I want to just make every moment really memorable and make all the big memories like prom and all the pep rallies and football games and just make them fun.
I'd like to invite you to stand as Blake Bratcher and Jessica Anderson lead us in our alma mater. Then we will have a recessional.
The wild cast will pass every test.
Thank you.